yeah, we're from Derbyshire. Derbyshire, to be precise. So I'll just tell you a little story. I used to live in the city of Derby. It's a bit of a shithole. No more of a shithole than Nottingham. That's not getting twisted. But I lived in Derby City and I thought, no, I've had enough of this. I've got two dogs, two young growing dogs. This is no place for them to be. We're going to move out to the hills, to the Pink District. So we did. And this is the story of the Pink District. Clap along with Owen if you like. Alright. So, when I was living in the city where it got a little shitty, so I moved to the sticks and the hills. They say the scenery is pretty, but the racism is a pity, with a few finger women on the tools. They stay alone in the street, they live in the town. The villagers are gossip and they frown. They were disgusted at what they saw, because I opened up my door, and yet some of my associates were brown. But they were living off the reggae, and we were eating off the chicken, and the barber came up through that spring. A British bulldog on his arm, when you're blind, you couldn't see it. Kind of funny when I heard the fella sing to you.
One love! One love!
So I won't be invited him next year, or his racist kids and wife. But if you're not white and British, why would you go to the racist village? There are many other places to visit. Please don't go to the racist village. I said if you're not white and British, why would you go to the racist village? Then I read it, but they won't admit it. The people of the racist village. So I'm sending in fire and I'm sending in nice, and I made a couple pals at the local. No one ever really speaks, and the beer's really cheap. I just take it that they're not playing vocal. So I'm sitting there, nothing else to do, I'm feeling awkward. I keep back and read my book, and there's a guy at the bar. I think he could be buzz-eyed, but is he giving me a feeler? So I get out of my chair, cause I want him with the pint, and I want a packet of the cheese crisps. He said, you moved to the college on the hill. I said, yeah. He said, whatever. I said, honey, your business. Now, maybe I was rude, and maybe I was rash. Maybe it's a cultural difference, but the grin in his eye while he's rubbing on his tie told me he a little bit of distance. Cause if you're not my good British, why would you go to the racist?
Thank you very much.
Thank you. True story. I left the racist village. Anyone ask why did I leave the racist village as a white British man? Well, I've got a couple of different dogs. One of them happens to be an Afro-Caribbean Jew. And he is.